We are going to learn how to make little puffballs, little puffball things like ones you put on hats, or ones you want to put on little bookmarks and things like that. I've got two, maybe three ways. First way is if you want to make big puffballs to put on hats and things like that, you're going to need strong cardboard. And this cardboard isn't the strongest. It's already, I've already made like three puffballs and it's already bending on me and stuff. But you're going to take some cardboard and you're going to cut it out probably about, I'd say about 2-3 inches apart. I mean, you're not going to get it exactly equal. I know I didn't. And another contraption, I've took two skewer sticks and hot glued them to foam balls. And this works really well. It's very sturdy. I'm going to make small one. I have yarn everywhere. I'm going to use this. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to start wrapping my string around these skewer sticks. Just hold your string right here with your thumb and wrap your string. You can make it however wide you want. Just go out however wide you want and then just keep wrapping inside the wideness of the... You can make it however thick you want. I'm going to cut it right here. Now you can take whatever color string you want for the next part. Like if you're going to be weaving this into a different color hat, you're going to want to blend it in when you sew it into the hat. Then you can use that color string. I'm going to use the same color string and I'm going to cut off a few inches of string. It's enough that I think I'm going to be able to use. And I'm going to take the middle, pull the string through the little holes here on either side. Put that string right through the middle and hold it, pulling it tight, flip it over. Now you're going to tie a knot ever how tight you want to. I usually tie mine 2 times. Like that. Now I like to go over it twice to get it tight, so I'm gonna put my string back through the loops and pull them out back over the other side to go around it. I'm going to tie it one more time. See, that gets it really tight now. Now I'm going to pull my string out of the way, because that's the string you're going to use to tie it into whatever you want to put it on. I'm going to take my scissors and I'm going to cut upside the string that's wrapped around these skewer sticks. This part is never going to be easy. It's going to be a little difficult until you get some little strands off there and it loosens up. Plus my scissors are super . First side is not too easy. Second side is easy because it doesn't have all the slats let off of it. So you can slip your scissors right up under there and cut it. just like this. Now it's off. Like, finally! Now I'm going to puff this out, just like this, and that purple blends right into it. If you want to cut on it a little bit, just push it up onto your fingers like this and hold it. You start cutting away at it to form it. You want the sides to be longer or shorter. I'm just going to cut it evenly. Make a bigger mess than I already have. And there's your little puffball. The same thing applies to bigger ones when you're using cardboard. You just wrap your string around it and then tie it off like I showed you with the small one, and you're going to cut the sides. I think using cardboard is probably easier when you start cutting. Of course, cardboard is very flimsy, so when you start tying it, it's going to push in the sides just like this. So you gotta make sure that whatever size you want, make sure the string is not pushing in the sides, because it'll make it smaller. And I need to get more cardboard. And that's it. There's your little puffball. Alright, now I'm going to show you how to make a tassel. Ones you could put on your scarves, or I have on the end of my bookmark right here. And first you're going to start out, you're going to need two crochet hooks, probably about the same size. Then you're going to need some string that you want to. I got a different multicolored purple and white. And I'm going to make a slip loop or slip knot. You're going to get that on one hook, just like that, and push it down to the bottom and put it through one finger, and then you're going to take the other one and put it on the other side of your index finger right here, and then you're going to wrap your string. Then I'm going to cut some string off. I am going to wrap my string close to the top here. Hold my string in the middle, and that way I can let go of my hooks. Then I'm going to take my left string I got here, my leftover string, and I'm going to pull it tight up at the top of where you want your tassel to be at the top, and I'm going to tie it in a knot. Now you can keep taking your string and wrapping it around to however thickness you want. This is kind of like making a puffball, set with a few different steps. And once I got that string tied enough, I can let go. I'm going to come down and start tying more knots in the gold hook I have. And I'm going to cut this string. Careful not to jab yourself. These scissors don't work very well. I'll pull that out. And any excess string, cut off. Now you have your little tassel. You can take your yarn needle, thread it through that little hole that you made. Add some string, marker, or something like that, and then tie it. And it's going to make this you keep round instead of more bulging out.